Let's begin exploring. Follow the markers down to the tracks. A train has just finished loading and is about to leave. Let's hop on board and go for a ride. There is much to do here on the Cane Creek Subdivision. Control heavy tonnage over the rugged and scenically beautiful Cane Creek Branch in Utah. Haul potash from the mine up to the main line, or operate the trains of a uranium mine cleanup site. Journey across open, arid plains and through narrow canyons past towering rock cliffs. Take control of your train and enjoy the challenges of this scenic branch line. We've only explored a small area here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to Cane Creek. Experience Utah's rugged canyons and remote desert country as you battle steep grades and haul heavy tonnage with contemporary Union Pacific diesel power. With Skyhook Games Train Sim World 2 Cane Creek. Along the way, don't forget to top up the water dispensers, pick up spiking hammers, pick up high visibility vests, and place points of interest posters on the point of interest boards. Welcome to Cane Creek. Welcome to Thompson. In this training module, we'll learn about operating the Union Pacific Electromotive SD40-2. The six-axle, 3,000 horsepower SD40-2 is one of the most successful diesel locomotives ever constructed, and the type remains in service. Almost all trains on the Cane Creek subdivision use two or more locomotives on the head end. We thus have to set up the diesels accordingly as lead and trailing units. Let's start by climbing aboard the trailing unit, which is the one farther to our left. Any trailing locomotive must have its control stand disabled so that it can receive commands from the lead unit. Check that the control, fuel pump, and engine run switch are in the off position. Trailing units also need to have their brakes set to cut out in trail 6 or 26. This is the default setting for all running locomotives at scenario start, so we can move on to the lead engine now. This is our lead engine, in other words, the unit we'll be operating from. We must thus switch on its controls. Our engine's controls are now active. Now we need to set the brakes for lead and the cut in to freight, which we can do with the two valves on the side of the control stand. Our two engines are now ready to run. Insert the reverser, set it to forward, release the brakes, and apply some throttle. Then drive to the destination marker and stop there. The path to your destination has been set for you in this scenario. Please be aware that there are numerous manual switches on the Cane Creek subdivision, and the engine crew must always ensure the switches ahead are aligned properly for its movements. Welcome to Potash. In this training module, we'll learn about operating the Union Pacific General Electric AC4400CW. The big AC4400CW is an example of state-of-the-art U.S. diesel locomotives with 4,400 horsepower and AC traction. You'll be the engineer of the two-unit lash-up right in front of you. Let's begin by preparing the units for service. Almost all trains on the Cane Creek subdivision use two or more locomotives on the head end. We thus have to set up the diesels accordingly as lead and trailing units. Let's start by climbing aboard the trailing unit, which is the one farther to our left. Any trailing locomotive must have its control stand disabled so that it can receive commands from the lead unit. Check that the control, fuel pump, and engine run switch are in the off position. Trailing units must also have their brakes set to cutout and trail. This is the default setting for all running locomotives at scenario start, so we can move on to the lead locomotive now. This is our lead engine. In other words, the unit we'll be operating from. We must thus switch on its controls. Our engine's controls are now active. Now we need to set the brakes for lead and cut-in, which we can do on any one of the three screens located on the control desks. Two units are now ready to go to work. Set the reverser forward, release the brakes, and apply a little throttle. Then carefully proceed to the destination marker and stop there. The path to your destination has been set for you in this scenario. Please be aware that there are numerous manual switches on the Cane Creek subdivision, and the engine crew must always ensure the switches ahead are aligned properly for its movements.